What's up, guys? What's going on? It is QNN Health and Wellness, Quest Nutrition Network. It's Quest. We're back again. Wanted to come to you guys real quick with this video. And this video is about morning rituals, morning routines. The video was inspired because I've always have been on a quest to learn the very best, learn from the very best, I should say, in regards to being successful. And I've always felt as though if you want to accomplish something in life, whether it's open a business, a successful business, have a very successful marriage, be a great father, it's always best to model after other individuals who have accomplished it already. Learn from the best, learn from the people who are out there doing it, and adapt some of their habits, adapt some of the things that they do, adapt some of their actions, their strategies. So one of the things that I have seen as a common thread amongst people who are CEOs of Fortune 500 companies, you know, individuals who have amassed a great amount of wealth, all right? One of the common threads are having a morning ritual, a morning routine, things that they do on a regular basis to get them mentally primed and pumped for the day. So I've adapted my own personal morning routine, and I'd like to share it with you guys. And if you like it, share it, and so on and so forth. So the very first thing that I do in my morning ritual, obviously, is waking up. You know, I get up at a particular time that works best for me. All right. So anywhere between 4:30 and 5:30 a.m. in the morning is the time that I wake up to get my day started. So first thing out of my top, the five things that I do on a regular basis is wake up. The second thing that I do immediately after waking up is going to the gym. All right. Getting myself a nice exercise routine on a regular basis gets me primed and pumped for the day. All right. So the first thing I generally do when I get to the gym is cardio. I get on the treadmill. I do some burpees, something that's going to get the blood flowing, get my heart pumping. You know, it's so important for me because even though I get up in the morning, I'm still tired. I'm still like dragging my feet. So I need that, you know, burst of energy to sort of open the eyes up. So that's the second thing. All right. The third thing in terms of the five things that I do for my morning routine, the third thing is the mental game. All right. Reading some type of information, some type of motivational book, as well as during my exercise routine. All right. One of the things that I do when I'm exercising is I very rarely listen to music. I'm usually listening to some type of motivational message to get my mind pumped and ready. All right. So anybody from Zig Ziglar to Les Brown to Tony Robbins to Jim Rohn, you know, last week, for a whole entire week, for example, I listened to documentaries as well as commentary and interviews by Kobe Bryant, which is a very, very fascinating individual because on the basketball court, Kobe is an assassin. You know, he's locked and he's loaded and he has prepared himself to be the very best. He prepared himself. He had that mindset that I have to be the very best basketball player on the planet, and he had a routine of things that he did on a regular basis. So I like to listen to those things as sort of fuel and understand the psychology of somebody who was one of the greatest at what he did. So those are some of the things I like to do in terms of the mental game. Also, as I said, reading. One of the books that I'm reading right now is, of course, the classic. Let me see if I have it here. Think and Grow Rich. I don't have it here. Think and Grow Rich is one of my all-time favorite books. I'm reading that right now, probably for my fifth time. And every time that I read it, it's really giving me even more golden nuggets. Or now, the level I'm at in my life, I'm receiving it differently. I'm also reading a book called Telomere Effect, great health book. but really just getting your mind in tune and ready for the day, pumped and primed and mentally sharp. All right. So as I said, as a recap, you're waking up, you're doing your exercise routine is number two. Number three is getting the mental game prepared, all right, with reading books and audio motivational messages. All right. So when you're done with your reading, and also let me just go back for a second. I generally read anywhere from a half an hour to 45 minutes in the morning time, depending on how early I wake up. So this is what, you know, works for me. And my exercise routine is generally half an hour, 45 minutes, sometimes an hour if I can get up early enough, like 4:30 or 4 o'clock. So it depends. It really depends. All right. So after you've done those things, after I've done those things, the next thing is a sort of mindfulness, a sort of meditation, which lasts for about a half an hour. And 15 minutes of that meditation is gratitude time. And 15 minutes is just strictly breathing and really focusing on my breathing and really just getting myself in tune for the day. All right. Gratitude is so important because we're constantly thinking about the things that we don't have. The things that the bills that we have to pay and may not have the money to pay for it. So it's so important to have that gratitude time of saying, hey, I'm really grateful for what is happening in my life, the things that haven't happened in my life. So this is a very, very important thing for me. And generally when I'm doing my gratitude time, you know, as I said, 15 minutes, hand on my heart, you know, that heart chakra, because you want to really have it really connected. You want it to really have a resounding effect of just really feeling that thankfulness and that gratitude of I'm really, really thankful that these things are happening in my life. So that's one of the things that I do to really have it, for it to have a meaning. You know, I read about that. You know, it's good to touch your heart when you're doing your gratitude time. And as I said, meditation, just really just not thinking about anything, thinking about your breathing, staying in tune, and possibly having some meditation music in the background, or maybe a candle, something that can really get you into that in-tuneness of your higher self. All right, so that's the fourth thing. And the fifth thing that I do is end things off with a prayer. Sometimes praying for other people, praying for my family, praying for my wife, for my two sons. You know, just some sort of a prayer to get yourself connected to that higher intelligence, that higher power. Some people call it God. Some people call it the Most High God, infinite intelligence, whatever your name is. The most important thing is to have that in-tuneness, that connection with that higher power. You know, that inner power, that strength, the source of everything. And, you know, that is my morning routine on a regular basis, all right? As I said, the times vary differently, half an hour sometimes for certain things, 45 minutes for certain things. But as I've read the information, the biographies of different people who are, you know, the best at what they do, the best businessmen, the best businesswomen, the very best athletes, this is a common thread, and hopefully this is something that you get something out of. I hope that you get something out of this. This is something for me on a personal level. It really gives me that mental edge. And I don't know about you guys, but I always want a mental edge. I always want some type of advantage point that I can have when I go into the day, because listen, we don't have control over the things that may happen during the course of the day. You know, if you're working in a corporate job, you might get hit with a deadline and say, hey, listen, you got to handle this by 5 o'clock today. You know, no holds barred. Your wife may call you and give you some news that she wants you to do something, or, you know, your kid, you know, all kinds of things happen throughout the day. But the one thing that you can take control over and you can have as sacred for yourself is that morning routine to get yourself locked in for the day, locked in and loaded and prepared to take over and smash that day in half and to accomplish everything that you've got. All right. One thing that is a bonus that I didn't mention, also writing your goals down, writing your goals, setting aside time to write the things that you want to accomplish for the day and also for that year, because there is a sort of this communication with your subconscious mind that gears you towards focusing and taking the action towards your goals when you writing them down on a consistent basis, and also reading them over when you write them. So that has been it in regards to my morning routine, my morning rituals. I hope that you like it. I hope that you've been inspired to have sort of a morning routine that works for you and that will help you to conquer the day and eventually become that success that you have been dreaming about and what you want for yourself, for your family, and what you want to accomplish for your business. All right. This has been Quest Nutrition Network. All right. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and hit like if you like it. Hit share if you like it. Thank you very much for taking the time to tune in. Take care. Peace.